Hey guys, Andrew Freund here in New York City, getting ready to talk about getting drunk with the cast of The Longest Ride. Ah!
The goal is pretty simple. Just hang on for 8 seconds.
Nothing to it.
Some bowls are nice like that.
The way you make me feel all sexy, but it's causing me shame.
You can only touch with your riding hand. All other touching's against the rules.
I wish I was allowed, but I don't want to cause any pain. Don't tell me listen to your song because it isn't the same.
We just come from such different worlds. I've never felt this way about anybody before.
All right, so I want to play a little game with you guys. Mix
Can't
it
wait.
Up. Games. We love games.
I love games.
Game called Who's More Likely To? Have a list of situations.
Yes, yes.
You tell
okay.
me. Right, you get the gist.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah.
Are you two prepared to take this challenge?
Yes.
Let's
right,
do it.
Eastwood likes it.
Okay.
First one, get really drunk line dancing.
Britt. Come on, Britt, for sure.
Yeah.
Why?
I know how to line dance. I love to get drunk, and I love to get drunk and dance. So the combination of the two is just, it's meant for
you
me.
Drunk line dancer, you.
What? That's me.
Did you two get drunk together and go dancing?
No. No, I don't.
Can you
dance
drink him under the table?
No.
We did get drunk together. We got drunk together a couple times.
Really?
I think so.
I don't think, maybe we've had a lot of cast dinners and stuff like
yeah,
that. So I would probably many of a time where
I've said some inappropriate
things.
A
few glasses of wine and, you know.
That's my barometer for getting drunk. It's like how many inappropriate things you say.
That, really?
You know, like when you start saying like something inappropriate, you're like, oh, like I might be drunk.
I'm curious. I have to ask, what is the most inappropriate thing you've ever said to a woman?
Yes.
Yes.
The most inappropriate thing I've ever said to a woman?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Come on. You don't want to say it? You afraid?
Come on, Eastwood. And now we got to know.
Man up, buddy. Man up. Nice tits.
Yeah, I probably call her sugar tits at some point.
He does, actually. That is pretty inappropriate.
Pull the Mel Gibson or
that
something.
That line was taken by Mel.
It was. It was Mel. It was a stolen thing from Mel Gibson.
Not everybody gets that.
You did.
For Ruth and I, wasn't that simple.
Baby, I'm thinking it over. What if the way we started made it something cursed from the start? What if it only gets colder? Would you still rock me every time that you think this was smart?
I'm fine. You're lucky to be alive.
What?
'Cause yeah, I've been scared of even thinking about where we are.
You need to make him understand that his riding days are over.
I know how hard it must be to give up that whole part of your life. You're kidding, right?
You have to quit. You have to.
I can't. This is what I do.
There ought to be some, like, group mooing at the end of the picture.
That's
that
a great
good?
Idea.
Watch the bouncing cow.
Hashtag moo.
Should we moo together? Should we all do a group moo?
Should we do a moo?
Okay, sure.
Let's do a moo.
One, two, three.
Moo. They don't actually say moo. They go moo.
Yes.
That's going to get you an Oscar.
You know, if there were an Oscar for mooing, they have so many categories. They need one like that.
For mooing.
Best moo.
Best
best moo in an interview.
What is your obsession with taking your shirt off? Please explain this to us.
I'd love to know as well.
Yeah.
That's really nice. You're going to get on his side? That's good.
No, I'm just curious. No sides should be taken.
I'm a California boy. And
yeah,
I
he
grew
loves
up at the
his
beach.
Body.
No, I grew up at the beach. I grew up surfing.
But
at the
like,
beach.
What were those photos that were? You were like wearing jeans and you have like a belt buckle.
Yes.
In Santa Monica.
That's his MO. Like that is literally just what he does.
That's cool.
One of the first times I ever hung out with him, we were doing. Well, I wasn't even hanging out with you.
Were you drunk?
No. We were rehearsing actually. We were rehearsing for the movie and we were outside like on a lot and he literally was just like, oh, it's hot. Takes off his shirt. Passes someone his phone and is like, Instagram this. Puts his cowboy hat down and is just like leaning back. I'm like, who is this guy? What is happening to me right now? It's like so confusing. But you know, it's just
I don't like when I'm hot. I don't like to sweat through a t-shirt because then you know, got to do more laundry. Just
true.
More laundry.
Good point.
Right?
So many
true.
Excuses.
And then yeah.
Finally, I want to see if you can give me the best impression of your dad.
Oh.
Shit.
That's cruel. Because what if he sees this and he's like, that's
and
horrible.
And he's like, that's not very good.
Yeah, I know. My son sucks.
You give me your best Clint.
Yes,
no idea.
I think that's way better.
No, what's so funny is, like, when we started shooting the movie, so many people would come in, like, we'd be, you know, in these van rides or whatever, and they'd be like, you look so much like your dad. God, you're a spitting image. And I'm like, I can't even recall your father looking like this. You know, I just know of him. Maybe I wasn't
he
a
was
film
when,
buff.
When he was younger, he did. Him
he
and
looked
I
like
did.
This?
Yeah, he did look like
this. Who knows? I could not do an impersonation of him, I don't think. There's no way.
Guys, it was...
He sort of just grumbles and growls a little.
Glint.
Sort of.
Whispers.
Yeah, sort of very quiet.
Yeah, he's got the eyebrow. He did the eyebrow.
Man's got to know his limitations.
That's good. That's good.
Sold.
Okay.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's 8 seconds. That girl could be the rest of your life.
Promise me it'll come back.
Promise.
I just don't know how to make this work.
I don't either, but I know that I want to. Don't tell me listen to your song
because it isn't the same. Love requires sacrifice. Always.